Sooner or later, you're going to do it. You're going to commit sensitive information to a Git repository, maybe a password, maybe an API key. Whatever it is, it's something not for public consumption, and by the time you find out, it's going to be too late. What can you do? Well, here's good news. Tools and techniques exist to help save your skin from exactly this kind of disaster. So in this video, I'm going to walk through three common ways to deal with having accidentally committed sensitive information to a Git repository. Let's take a look at each one of them in turn. First, let's start with a simple repository that has some sensitive data in it. When I first created this repo, I checked in a file that had an API key in it. On realizing my mistake, I moved the key into a separate file, but the problem still remained. I had the key committed in the repo. Finally, I tried adding a gitignore file to keep the key out, but that only prevented the key file from being added in future commits. It didn't undo the previous ones. Now, the first thing we could do is simply delete the entire repository and start over. And since I'm only a few commits into the process, that wouldn't be the worst solution here. I just have to delete the .git subdirectory, problem solved. But what if that is not an option? For instance, if we have a project with many, many commits. Option number two is to use one of Git's own built-in functions, git filter branch. This command lets you rewrite the commit history of a repository by applying some custom filter to each commit's files. In essence, it checks out each commit, lets you do something with it, and then stores the changes back in the commit. Now, to do the filtering in this example, I've written a little Python script which loops through all the files in the tree, save for what's in the Git directory itself, and substitutes out any text that it finds matching our key. So to run this, first we have to make a clone of our repository. We don't want to work on the original. We change into it, and we run git filter dash branch using our script as the command to apply to each branch. You'll notice that when we run the command, we get this giant warning. Git filter branch is tricky to use well, and it has other disadvantages we'll soon see in detail. But once it does run, we can take a look at the Git history for our project, and you'll notice that every spot in the history where we once had the key, we now have the censored version of it instead. Now comes the big problem. Filter branch is slow. For perspective, let's go to another project that has several hundred entries in its commit history. I'm going to make a clone of this project, switch into the clone directory, and rerun our tree filtering command here. And once again, we get the warning. And once the filtering process itself starts, you'll notice it takes a long time to process each individual commit. For repositories with lots of files and lots of commits, you're going to be here for quite some time. At least you get some estimate of how long things are going to take. Let's exit out of this and go to our third solution. It's a third-party program, and it's the very one Git itself recommends as a substitute in that warning message. It's called Git Filter Repo, written in Python. This tool solves many problems you might have with sensitive data in Git repos. It also deals with many other kinds of issues you have in the same vein, like rewriting commit messages or performing other kinds of surgery. And it's much faster than using filter branch. So for this particular operation, we have to create a file that describes the kinds of replacements we want to make. In this case, it's just a literal substitution, but we could use regular expressions or other more complex operations if we had to. So now we'll clone our repository, once again, for our small project, go into the clone, and run the git filter repo command. And because this isn't very large, it should complete very quickly. And once again, if we open the clone repo, we can see that all of the commits have been rewritten to remove the offending data. Now let's clone that other bigger project I demonstrated earlier and run git filter repo on that one using our search and replace. Now my point is not that this project actually has a key that needs sanitizing. It's that I want you to see just how quickly we're tearing through all of these commits compared to the git filter branch approach. So, to sum up, if you've got a Git repository that has sensitive data stuck in it, the easy approach is to destroy the repository and start from scratch. Git's built-in filter branch command can also work, at the cost of being slow and potentially buggy. But the Git filter repo tool, while it is an external tool that uses Python, it's just a single file that could handle the vast majority of your use cases for this problem. So that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below, and don't forget to follow Devith Sirdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.